So let's say that you've got some awesome Android game with hundreds of thousands of downloads, but it seems like you can't break that million user mark. The reason? Users are unhappy with your game's performance. You see, users notice bad performance before any other feature in your game, before your item stats or your UI interfaces or how in level 3 one of your characters is actually speaking Klingon. And guess what? Users unhappy with performance give bad reviews at a higher percentage than any other problem in your game. So you want to break the million user mark? You're going to have to fix the perf problems in your game. And for modern Android games, that starts with understanding that there exists a delicate dance, a tango, if you will, of interaction between the CPU and GPU in your game that can have a drastic impact on your performance. And the dance works a little something like this. Modern graphics APIs don't allow the CPU to talk directly to the GPU hardware. Instead, it uses an intermediate process known as a graphics driver to handle communication between the two. Drawing calls from the CPU are cached by the driver in a message queue, and when the GPU hardware is ready for work, it will start consuming commands from the same resource and begin executing on them. The existence of the message queue process in the driver means the CPU can be pushing messages into the driver at a different rate than the GPU is reading from it. And as such, your GPU can be consuming, processing, and drawing data that's around 1 to 2 frames behind the CPU. Now, while alarming, don't worry, this is actually really typical of modern hardware architectures. But with this in mind, understand that hitting 60 frames a second in your game requires both your CPU frame and your GPU frame to both complete their work in around 16 milliseconds. When either of these two systems starts to go out of sync and take longer than that, bad things happen to your frame rate. For example, what if your GPU has more work to do than your CPU? This means that your CPU is going to be submitting frames into the driver at a faster frequency than the GPU is actually going to be consuming them. Eventually, the driver queue is going to get filled, and anytime the CPU wants to submit a driver call, it'll have to block, wait for the GPU to clear up some commands in order to free up space, at which point the CPU can then carry on and submit its new commands. On the other hand, if you're CPU bound, then you're inserting bubbles into your GPU pipeline. Every time the CPU submits a frame, the GPU will consume it immediately, process it, and sit around waiting for the next frame where it can do work again. The straightforward way to fix this is to simply do less work on the CPU. But in this case, it may be that the GPU simply doesn't have enough work to do, and the correct action is actually to give it more work in order to fully maximize the GPU throughput. There's a great opportunity to put like 200 extra zombies on the screen for your designers. You can get a general estimate of where the problem lies by taking a good look at your CPU frame time for a couple seconds of simulation. For example, if your CPU frame time is around 16 milliseconds, then your game is running pretty well. Now, while your goal is to keep things under the 16 millisecond mark, some frames your CPU load changes and you expect slight variances in the time. If, however, your frame time starts to spike suddenly and your CPU computation load hasn't changed, you know, you haven't put 200 zombies on the screen, then there's a high probability that this is due to the GPU getting backed up, forcing your CPU time to stall in the driver. These tall spikes are actually pretty telling, since they're around 11 to 15 milliseconds in time, which would be exactly how long the GPU would need to flush a frame or so. In order to figure out what the culprit really is, it's time to sit down and get proficient with mobile profiling tools. Some of the nuances of the GPU performance require dedicated tools to discover, but thankfully, each Android chip manufacturer provides a great suite of tools to give you more information on how to optimize your game for their hardware. Understanding and optimizing the dance between the CPU and GPU is the first step in maximizing your game's performance, which of course results in happier users, which could result in better transactions, and that's the whole point, right? So keep calm, profile your code, and as always, remember, perf matters.